morning, you guys. FSC Trucking. Just unloaded the fire truck here in Jersey City over at the Port Authority garage. Figured out yesterday that the best place to unload it is here rather than where they originally thought, over at Erie Street, two blocks to the west of here. There's just more room here. Plus, it was a good area to camp out for the night. So, nice open parking right here. There were other trucks parked here that work with this company right here to my left, but it worked out good. So with that, we're gonna proceed up to the Vince Lombardi Service Plaza. We'll spend the day there. What we're gonna do is wait to get the truck back. The truck is going to the New York Stock Exchange to be displayed and showed off to the, I guess, NYPD and Port Authority bigwigs and so forth. And then they're gonna bring it back to me. So with that, we're gonna go sit underneath the bridge of Vince Lombardi, since we don't have no air in this truck, and just kind of bask in the shade a little bit, rest up for the day, get some editing done, get a bunch of work done, and then we're gonna come back down tonight. So with that, let's go ahead and get this today started. Oh wait a minute, I already got today started, never mind. Well, either way, let's get going. maybe. Makes sense. This bridge looks brand new. Now, what do I know? I don't live here no more. Neither does my family.
Thank you.
What's up, you guys? FSC Trucking. Well, after a day of waiting at the Vince Lombardi Service Plaza under the bridge, the turnpike goes over, and hoping the cops don't give me hell for trying to sit in the shade and stay cool, I came down here to pick up the Pierce fire truck, the half electric one. Well, they're calling it an EV. It has a smaller, like a pickup truck style size diesel as a backup. It's sitting right there. We just got done loading it up, tied down. We dropped it off earlier this morning after getting here, and then we went up to Vince Lombardi, hung out. They brought her down to New York Stock Exchange, had it on TV. The guy said something about, I think the show Mad Money was on there. So they had it over there, then he brought it on, you know, then he brought it back over here for me to load and bring back to Wisconsin. Let's go check it out real fast, see what I can find. Now, I don't know a god awful lot about this truck, but all I can tell you is this. It's for Portland, Oregon, and they're using it as a demo unit to show it off to the big wigs out in Manhattan. Of course, we're in Jersey City, just a hop, skip, and a jump through the Holland Tunnel to get to New York City from here. So I don't know how they brought it over there, but they did. They were out there for, they were out there basically all day. So now we got her loaded. You can see the setting sun and the shadow. So now we're getting ready to get out of here, but I want to show it to you. So long story short, it's an Enforcer chassis. Don't mind a reefer on the other side of the road here, but it's got a diesel engine as a backup. I don't know where the battery pack is. I'm guessing it's that little thing right there where the number one is. Perhaps that's where it is, I don't really know. Either way, they're calling it Enforcer Volterra. But basically it's an Enforcer chassis with a revamped driveline, battery power, smaller diesel, and that's what it does. I will tell you this though, he did tell me he drove it into Manhattan and back from Manhattan here, all on electric power, and it did real good getting up on the trailer. There's no debate anywhere that I know of that electric vehicles have a lot of torque as far as like getting up a trailer, getting somewhere fast, whatever. Problem is always the battery. Well, we'll see how they do. I don't know much about it. All I know is they build them, they pay me to haul them. As far as I'm concerned, that's it. All right, well, what about the channel? For me, the real star of the show sits right here. This is Orwell. Orwell is my 1984 Peterbilt. For those that are new to the channel, Peterbilt made a 362 cab over back in 1984. If you've ever read the book 1984, meet Orwell. Look at the days we're living. That's all I'll say about that. All right, so with that, we're gonna go ahead and set the GoPros up, fire them up, and get on out of here. Let's go. Alrighty, boys and girls, we're ready to go. Basically. I'm gonna start to fast up. I know of up there in East Rutherford, Moonaki area. Don't go there much. But it's much cheaper than the big name truck stops. It's a one-way road, so I can make the turn and go right directly into the left lanes.
Thank you.
pulled out of road. Because it was so much cheaper than everywhere else, the truck stops, the bigger ones, would inflate the price because, you know, it was a little cheaper than Pennsylvania, a little cheaper than New York, a little cheaper than Connecticut, but way more expensive than a normal fuel stop in New Jersey. I'm talking your TAs, your pilots, Petro, stuff like that, right? So you can find these little fuel discounters, and not much more than gas stations with diesel pumps big enough to get a semi-truck in. One in Edison I used to go to a lot. I still do every now and again. But that got taken over by Pilot, and I think Pilot let it go. I think they figured that, I don't know, maybe there wasn't enough fuel volume or whatever. But when Pilot took over, the diesel prices went way high. Now up here, once Pilot bought this one up too, it'll be much cheaper than the Pilot or the TA. At least that's how it used to be. Considering Indiana fuel was $5.29 a gallon when I bought it in Indiana. Let's see what it is here. Remember, Indiana used to be a cheaper fuel. that's a limo. I can't read that on the corner of the trunk. I can make the right turn from the right lane if I was a car. But the turn is very tough, so you gotta make it really wide. Stilettos. The guy that owns that is the guy that owns the property that somebody did a special on, and they think Jimmy Hoffa is buried in a barrel not that far from here. But the guy that owns that strip club is the guy that owns that property, supposedly. That's what I've seen on TV. And no, I've never been in that strip club. I don't even know if it's still around, like, open.